For the medical watch, taking away the pain without pills.
Medical reporter Dina Baer has more on a promising new device.
There's a dire need to find alternatives to opioids, the highly effective but highly addictive medications. Now, local engineers are going directly to the source to stop the pain.
In this Northwestern University lab, it's all about tiny devices that make a big impact. From sensors that measure vital signs for babies in the neonatal intensive care unit, to devices that track recovery in stroke patients, Professor John Rogers' latest project is pain.
Managing and treating pain is a very important part of patient care. Drug-based approaches, such as those that rely on opioids, are really spectacularly effective. But they have various side effects, including extreme levels of addiction.
Instead of popping a pill, Dr. Rogers wants to implant this flexible strip.
It's an implantable device. It's a soft kind of rubbery device that gently envelops a targeted nerve. It could be a nerve bundle. It could be an individual nerve fiber.
The devices, tested on the sciatic nerve in animal models, contain microfluid channels that deliver a cooling liquid directly to selected peripheral nerves. The coolant slows pain signals, eventually stopping them from traveling to the brain.
There are a whole number of different processes that decrease and slow down when you reduce the temperature of the tissue. And the net effect of that in the context of nerves is that the nerve signals can no longer propagate.
An electrical conduction system made on site at the lab controls the flow of coolant and measures temperature. Think of it like an on-off switch.
You can dial in the magnitude of the pain relief that's being provided. And so we think that's an important, powerful distinction between kind of an engineering approach and a chemistry approach.
Encased in flexible polymer, the device is designed to be implanted at the time of a surgery. It stays in the body for days to weeks, then dissolves.
It's designed to naturally melt away and dissolve and disappear in the body, much like a resorbable suture. Treating pain is such a challenging thing. It's so essential, though, to patient care that if we can kind of move the needle and add to the set of options that physicians have around, you know, relieving pain, we think that could be a good way for us to contribute as engineers.
The next step is to test the coolant for longer periods of time to determine how much is needed to be effective without damaging the nerve. Back to you.